The first four events of the NHRA Pro Modified Series have been played with unpredictable weather. But now, with the first half of the season almost over, the blown alcohol cars have finally been presented with near-perfect conditions. In some cases, it was too much of a good thing. But a couple of things are finally for sure. Records will go down, and spirits will be up at the Englishtown, New Jersey edition of the AMS Staff Leasing Pro Mod Series. Coming up next. The lady stands proudly greeting all who come to New York City, the United States of America, and we're here in Englishtown, New Jersey, just south of New York City, as we continue our coverage here on ESPN2 of the AMS Pro Modified Series. Hello again, everyone. I'm Ted Jones in the pit area of Mike Ashley, who has made quite a disturbance this year in the Pro Modified ranks. First of all, welcome back. You were one of the pioneers.
Yeah, I'm happy to be back. I'll tell you, it's tough, though, this time around. There's a lot of competition out here, but we're keeping up pretty good, aren't we?
Yeah, and, you know, a lot of pressure on you. Now, tell me the truth. How many fans did you bring out of the Big Apple here to Englishtown?
There's got to be at least three or four of them up there in those stands, I tell you.
Three or 400?
My wife and my kids are up there. I know that. Now, I think we got a lot of fans. We got a pretty good following from past history of the sport.
Yeah, this has been a lucky track for you, right?
Oh, yeah. Englishtown's been a lucky track. We set our first world record here back in 1990, so I love this track. It's a great facility. I'm looking forward to racing here.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, will Mike Ashley be among those to qualify? Brett Kepner has that report coming up right now.
Well, there's no question that the 33rd annual NHRA Powerade Matco Tools Supernationals here at Old Bridge Township Raceway Park in Englishtown, New Jersey is just another chapter in our book entitled 2003, the year of the weirdest weather in drag racing history. And we've already been through the entire supercharge versus nitrous oxide injected scenario as far as which types of cars benefit from changing weather conditions, whether it gets hotter or it gets colder. Problem is, every race that was supposed to be hot has been cold. Every race that's been cold has been skyrocketing temperatures, but Englishtown tops them all. Qualifying here, the first day of actual runs down the track was miserable. The conditions were horrible, hot, humid, nobody could do anything. But the second day dawned frigid. I mean, not just chilly, it was cold. High temperature of 49 degrees, a tailwind, a cold racetrack, and of course, a tremendous number of incredibly quick and fast runs by supercharged methanol burning Pro Modifieds. Certainly the most spectacular incident of qualifying came from Chip King. You remember him as the runner-up at the O'Reilly Auto Parts Spring Nationals in Houston with his supercharged Dodge Avenger. A supercharger explosion down track caused a tremendous amount of high pressure to build up underneath the fiberglass nose of that car, and poof, everything gone. And that was just the beginning of King's horrible weekend. They fixed the front end, couldn't get the car down the track, and then in the final qualifying session, the batteries died, and he couldn't even fire up for a chance to qualify here. You had to go quicker than 6.31 seconds just to get in this show, but performance was the name of the game. Let's start off with Fred Hahn and Jim Otte. The Summit Racing Equipment 2002 Corvette struggled all through qualifying, including this wild wheel-standing launch that sent driver Fred Hahn right for the wall in the second qualifying session. They came out of the best atmospheric conditions of the event, 200 feet below sea level, corrected altitude in the final session. 6.16 seconds, the quickest run in NHRA AMS Staff Leasing Pro Modified history. The speed, 229.70 miles per hour, an all-time high for these cars in NHRA competition. Let's not forget Tim McAmis, who actually pedaled, got on and off the throttle, and ran 6.19. Then, of course, there was another 6.16 by Thomas Patterson, the driver who's probably stepped up harder than anybody else this year in his Houston-based Primer and Flame 63 Corvette. But those three, even though they qualified at this event under the current AMS Pro Modified ET record, stood by themselves behind the leader. Bob Rieger, the guy who said he was not going to drag race anymore in this incredible ARP-sponsored 57 Chevrolet, unleashed the run of NHRA AMS Pro Modified racing. 6.15 seconds at over 226 miles per hour. To lead the field, he has not yet backed up that elapsed time for a new ET record, but could easily do so here on race day, where conditions are actually better. For the first time, we've got heat in the racetrack, and that means traction will be better than it was in those frigid qualifying periods. This could be a numbers race like we've never seen, but I got bad news for the nitrous racers. Only one carbureted car qualified for this field. Ricky Smith will stage up in the first round against Fred Hahn as the only hope for the Nitrous fans.
This coverage of the AMS Pro Modified Series from Englishtown, New Jersey is brought to you by AMS Staff Leasing, Business Solutions for the Construction Industry, and by ARP, Manufacturer of Aerospace Quality Fasteners. We'll be back with elimination. They still have doors.
For more information on the NHRA AMS Staff Leasing Pro Mod Challenge, log on to amspromods.com.
Back in Englishtown, New Jersey, the Matco Tools Supernationals, a part of the AMS Staff Leasing Pro Modified Circuit. We're ready to go. Starting out with Mike Ashley, the number six qualifier, whom we ask about a home track advantage.
I think a hometown advantage is going to be a big help for me because I love this racetrack. I've always done pretty good here, and I think it's time to give my team a win. So I feel pretty good about this deal. I know Thomas Patterson was real tough, but I think today's going to be our day. I think today's going to be the day for Gotham City.
And qualifying in the number three position, Thomas Patterson with that supercharged Corvette. We talked to him about track conditions for this particular event.
I think the track's going to be good. We should be repeating some times.
Can you lower the record even further?
Oh, we're going to shoot for it. You know we are.
We'll find out in just a minute. Joining me in the booth right now, Kenny Nowling.
Thomas Patterson looking to get to his third final in a row, Ted. Mike Ashley looking to put on a show for the home crowd.
Mike Ashley putting on that show. Patterson, a little bobble there, was forced to lift and correct. Ashley, 622, 225 miles per hour. That's no new record, but that's pretty darn fast. And then Bob Rieger, who just returned. Brett talked with him about it.
You know, for those of you who are true hot rodders out there, you got to credit Bob Rieger. He's driving a fire engine red 57 Chevy. He's listening to the stereo in the car in the staging lanes before eliminations. I want one answer from you. What are you doing here?
Having a good time. That's it. That's what this is all about. Having a good time.
You said you weren't coming back. You said, that's it. I'm selling this thing.
Well, you know, it's racing's a real tough deal. We had a real tough start, and we got really upset. We had a lot of problems, and it kind of looked like we got to hang it up. Everybody got together one last minute, one last time, and we all said, you know, there's something missing. We didn't get something right. We all felt we left something on the table. The whole team came together and says, let's go do it. So we jumped back in the rig day before the race, came back here, slapped the car out on the track, and had a couple problems. I've been uncomfortable with a car. I've been street racing for a while, and the street cars are a little bit different than a pro mod car. I've never ran a blower before, never had a handbrake before, and it was kind of difficult for me. I finally figured out the problem was I was in the car as a driver, but I wasn't driving the car. So went to bed the other night, and I woke up, and I go, you know, that's what it is. And I came back, and I says, this is my car. I'm driving. I'm going down the track. And things got better. The lights got better, stage better, and the whole crew came together, and we ended up number one spot. It was great. It was like a dream come true.
Rieger, who qualified number one, will face the number eight qualifier, Tommy Gray. What does he think about having to run the number one guy, especially considering that number one guy was running in the teams?
We're not worried about that number one. We're going to try to do our own thing here. And with the weather as good as it is, there ought to be a lot of real good runs out there. Plus, we get to wear our new jackets for the first time this year. But, we're going to stick with our same game plan and see what happens and let her rip.
A 57 Chevrolet against a 53 Corvette, a beautiful 53 Corvette, Kenny.
Yeah, Ted, the fans love this car, one of the most popular cars in any form of drag racing. Tommy Gray, the Undertaker car, with backing from AMSPEO.com out of Dallas, Texas.
Tommy is actually an Undertaker. For real, folks, Bob Rieger out on him slightly. Now look at the horsepower. Wow, that 57 Chevrolet dominated. There's another 615. That backs the first one up, and the crew knows it. Are they ever happy or what?
Stereo blaring away. Yes, it actually is on during the run.
How'd I do? I didn't get it.
How'd it feel?
Oh, it felt great. Felt like it hauled. It did good.
Feel like a 15 with a 1?
Yeah, baby. creeped in the lights, man. It stayed first. I didn't mean to. I just creeped in the lights. I was worried the thing was going to pull right through and I was going to red light. But, boy, I guess we just made it on time. So.
Another question for you. What's 228 feel like?
Yeah, that was pretty good. We're in for another round. This is great. Thank you.
Next up, Tim McAmis, the chassis builder. We talked to him about setting the car up for kill, considering track conditions.
We don't have to, but we've got it set on kill. I mean, we want to go up there every run and set the ET record if we can. I mean, this is really tough. I mean, this is some of the best racing there is, and if you don't go up there with everything you got in the trailer, you're going to go home early.
And another 53 Corvette, Troy Critchley. We ask him, is your car ready for this race here at English Town?
The car seems to be good right now, and everything seems to be there. You know, we put a new belt on it, so this is about all we didn't replace during the week. So hopefully the conditions are fairly good, you know, a little bit of heat in the track, and it should be all good, yeah.
The number 4 and 5 qualifiers from the middle of the field. Critchley out of St. Joe, Michigan. McAmis out of Hawk Point, Missouri.
Spent some time at Tim McAmis' shop this week, Ted. You will not find a more consummate professional in this class. He is a racer's racer.
Two favorite cars. Oh, problems right away for McAmis. Then Critchley has the lift. That gets back in it. He'll pick up the win right there. The number's not spectacular, but hey, he goes into the semifinals. I'm sure that's all he cares about. Now, meanwhile, here comes Freddie Hahn driving Jim Oddie's car. We ask him about the conditions.
I don't know if this is perfect conditions, but it sure is conditions to go fast, you know. And we feel we can go as fast as anybody else in these conditions. We feel we have a little better hot weather tune-up than some of the blower guys do in 85-degree weather, but... you know, we went out there, went a 6:16 at 2:29 and some change. So, I mean, that's the top mile an hour of the meet. So, obviously, I mean, the motor makes enough power to run in these conditions also. So, we'll go out there today, and I'm sure we'll be able to run with the best of them, I hope. That's what we're planning on.
His opponent, the only nitrous-injected car in the field, as Brett pointed out earlier. We talked to Ricky Smith about being the only nitrous-injected car.
Do conditions like this make you wish there was something else you could do?
Yes, sometimes, Brad. We tore up stuff again yesterday. You know, we was on a pretty good run yesterday morning. Probably was going to run 25, 26, and burn it up and run it to 30. But we patched it up last night, and we know we was down probably 100 horsepower. And it run a 31, so we just got to go out there today and race these guys. And even if the motor was in good shape, we're not going to beat them unless they mess up. So we got to go out there and try to go to the other end and hope they shake, red light, do something wrong, you know.
Remember the difference. Ricky, 706 cubic inches. Freddie Hahn with 526 cubic inches. Starting line advantage right there, Ricky Smith.
You know, Scooter Pico and the guys at Summit have got to be thrilled about the exposure they're getting over here within the NHRA, Ted.
Well, especially when their car just beat Ricky Smith. 6:18. He's in this drag race, folks. Here's the way they'll stack up going into the semifinal round. Rieger against Critchley, and Hahn will face Ashley. Brett's there.
When you name your racing operation Gotham City Competition, and you're racing 30 miles south of New York City, you'd better be on your game. If you've got all these people here to watch, all these people that you want to impress, and you're up against a bunch of cars that have run mid-16s, and you've gone a 6:22, what's the game?
Well, you know what? The game is consistency, and consistency wins drag races. I mean, I know that I got Fred Hahn next round, and he went 6:18, and we went at 6:22, but he's going to have to repeat that 18, and I feel like we can repeat that 22, or even maybe go with 20 this time. So we'll see. I still think I'm in the hunt. I think it's anybody's game, but I think we're going to come out with the win today.
Hey, one thing for sure, if he does turn on the wind light this time, it'll be the largest roar of the crowd all day long.
Back in Englishtown, New Jersey, at the NHRA Matco Tools Supernationals, we're covering the AMF Staff Leasing Pro Modified Circuit. Ready now for the semi-final round of those Pro Modifieds, featuring Freddie Hahn from Elma, New York, driving Jim Oddie's potent Summit Racing Equipment sponsored car, and this guy, the hometown favorite, Mike Ashley.
I spent some time over at Linda America on Thursday, Ted, with Mike Ashley. If he starts to succeed on the track like he's doing in business, this guy's going to set the world on fire.
Well, it's all about reaction times right now. Hahn, plenty tough on the tree, has Ashley start just slightly off the starting line. Oh, now Ashley forced to shut it down. Probably tire shake problems. Hahn moves into the final. 6:17, 230, another team. Boy, this track is great.
A 6:17 proves that you've got a consistent combination. But more importantly, You're the first 230-mile-an-hour driver in AMS Pro Mod history.
Really? Well, that's just great. We're just trying to be consistent here. We figured if we could just be consistent, we could get to the final.
No. I'm sorry. You'll have to back up. Going 230 miles per hour is not an attempt to be consistent.
Well, that's consistent on the ET part. That's all we're really concerned about here.
Don't tell me that you drove at the 230.80 miles per hour thinking you were going easy on it.
Well, he told me not to drive it deep, so I think I clicked it a tad early. But no, I'm joking, of course, you know. The Summit Corvette here is just running good today, and we're happy to be here at Matco Tools.
Just running good. And we're happy to be here.
Yeah, we are. We're just thrilled to be here. At any
track records mean nothing in Englishtown to you.
Oh, yes, they do. We've had plenty of them. We hope to set plenty more, but it's the next round that really counts.
Jousting a little bit on top end right there. 230 is pretty good, though. Bob Rieger will be our next semifinals in the one qualifier against Troy Critchley.
Troy Critchley driving for Thomas Patterson and Richard Patterson, the PMS excavating Corvette. Troy's actually moving to Houston this week. He's going to leave St. Joseph's, Michigan behind and head down to Houston. Jim Geese Vanishing Point Race Cars is on a heck of a streak here, Ted. Three final rounds in a row, Troy can get past Bob.
Nice hole shot by Critchley, 461. Let's see what happens. Oh, what a race, folks. Barely at the finish line, Troy Critchley. The 57 Chevy of Rieger was coming on strong. Take a look at just how close it was at the finish line. That's a pretty close drag race.
All right, you're running a guy who's gone 6:15. You've never gone a teen in your life, so what do you have to do?
Run faster than him?
No.
What?
Tree him to death.
Tree him to death? Is that what we did?
29 to a losing 25, 4:16, Bob.
Very nice. That's what we had to do.
That's exactly what you had to do. There wasn't any other way out of that one.
No, sir. Yeah, that's pretty good pass. I think we got a bit of a problem with the hot rod, but we got there first.
Yeah, so I don't think we've solved all the deals there.
Yeah, no, doesn't look like it by the way the belt looks like hanging out the front of the engine.
Ooh, early shutoff, 6:29, huh?
No.
I think they were both at 2:26, so no, it wasn't. You're in the final. That's all that matters.
You. Thanks,
great
mate.
Great job.
Well, he just dropped out the number one qualifier, so I'm sure Freddie Hahn doesn't scare him one bit. We'll have a great final coming up. Between Freddie Hahn and Troy Critchley, a 2001 Corvette against a 53 Corvette. Time now for Pro's Pick, brought to you by AMS Staff Leasing.
This week's AMS Staff Leasing Pro's Pick is about something that's on every race car out here but doesn't get a lot of talk. Headers. Every competitive race car, whether it's a super stock or a Pro Mod, has headers. And I'm here with Bill Hill, the driver of the AMS Staff Leasing 57 Chevrolet Pro Mod. Bill, headers in race cars have been important for a lot of years, but going into the new class of Pro Mod within NHRA, the performance level needs to be up.
We have a lot less leakage with the Headman headers, and also the angle of the pipes coming out, which is creating a lot more downforce for these cars, and we need as much as we can when you're running 230 mile an hour.
You mentioned downforce. Downforce actually plays a key role in the design of the header?
Absolutely. The angle of the pipes, if it's too far out, and you have a cylinder go out, it can push the car left or right, depending on which side the cylinder goes out on. So if the angle's up, the force is down, and it's not going to change your driving of the car as you're going down the track as much.
Now, I don't imagine you carry three or four sets of these in the trailer on any given weekend. If you have a problem with the header, how do you get it fixed here at the racetrack?
Well, we carry a welder on board, and we also have the option of going up to the Headman trailer up in the Midway, and they can repair anything that we do to them.
Well, it's obvious that the performance with Headman headers is there. And if you watch this next round of AMS Staff Leasing competition, you're going to see a lot of Headman headers putting up impressive numbers.
This is the car, the original Headhunter machine, originally purchased from Don Fegley, who lived here on the East Coast, that went 6:16 2 years ago when Thomas Patterson was driving it before he hired this guy, Troy Critchley, from Australia to drive it. The owner always gets the new car, right?
Yeah.
Did you even figure out what happened in the first round? Why did the car shake? Why did it slow down?
Just had too many beans, I think. Yeah, hopped it up a bit and didn't take enough clutch out of it, you know.
But can you afford to back it down against a car that went 6:15?
Oh, we never back them down.
Can this car go another 16 like it did two years ago?
I hope so. I'd like to run my first teen here today.
That's right. You've been on a whole bunch of 2-0s, but never a teen.
Yes.
2-0s in what? Three different cars now.
Yeah, rub it in. Go on.
All right. Teens are the name of the game. If he does it, it'll be history.
Back in Englishtown, Bob Rieger received the AMSPromods.com top qualifier check, $2,000. ProMod Profiles, a close look at the pro-modified stars that run the AMS ProMod series.
Well, over at the Headhunter pit area, Troy Critchley and Thomas Patterson believe they have figured out their problem. They're going to need to because they know they're up against the wall. It's not just the car that's gone the fastest speed ever for any vehicle at 2,700 pounds. It's not just one of the serious crowd favorites here at Englishtown. It's a man who has done absolutely astonishing things at this racetrack ever since it was built back in the mid-1960s. When Fred Hahn and Jim Oddie and their Summit Racing Corvette show up at this racetrack, you got to figure big things are going to happen. But remember all that stuff we talked about with the Troy Critchley and Thomas Patterson similarities between their cars, 616 and Vanishing Point race cars and all that other stuff? Well, believe it or not, Aussie Troy Critchley has something in common with the Summit Racing Corvette, and I'll bet Jim Oddie knows what it is.
That'd be built in Australia by his good buddy,
good old Murray Anderson.
That's the guy. That's the guy.
But not many people realize this is an Australian design chassis.
Correct. Yeah, that's right. Murray had this on the drawing board, and we spent a lot of time designing a body for it, and you know where to put the tubing, and it's pretty much his design of where everything is.
And if I'm not mistaken, I don't want to say that you got an idea from somebody, or it was probably an original tune, but it was Scotty Cannon who first showed up with a Murray Anderson chassis that you saw on a blown door slammer, right?
Yeah, that's correct. Scotty went over there and did some match racing and kind of fell in love with the car he was just driving and brought it back home with him.
And has it changed the way you look at chassis science that much?
Well, it's just we're kind of looking for something a little bit different, and you know, it's a harder, tougher job to get something from over there, and discourages a lot of people from doing it. So if we do come get on to something, it just maybe we have it for another 10 minutes.
Yeah, almost 231 miles an hour at 2,700 pounds. You may have gotten onto something.
Yeah, the aero package is starting to show me some numbers because the motor's not really working that awful hard, but the numbers on the board look really great.
But we're talking to a guy that won the NHRA U.S. Nationals in 1972. You've basically accomplished pretty much everything you could want to accomplish in drag racing, but here you are in something you never dreamed probably was possible, a Pro Mod Final in an NHRA National event at Englishtown. Is this as big as 72 Indy?
Yeah, it really is, and it's funny, too, because I flashed back to 72 at Indy for the fun around sitting in the staging lanes, and I fell asleep in the car. They had to come over and open the door and wake me up. It's just, I don't know, you just get into a zone where you're really thinking about what to do with the car and what could happen and what might not happen, and just kind of, you block everything else, you get in a zone where it's just a calm place to be when you're thinking about all the things you want to make sure is proper for this race.
But what he doesn't realize is that for years at Englishtown, they called this Pro Oddie, and they may still be calling it that after this final round.
This coverage of the AMS Staff Leasing Pro Modified Challenge brought to you by Barroso Performance Product, race proven, and by United Specialties, home of the Trend Center. And we have just enough time to remind you for all the latest news and notes from the world of motorsports, and for all the latest from NHRA, visit rpm.espn.com, keyword NHRA. Well, it's finals time, folks, and Pro Mod, there is Freddie Hahn, who has to be the favorite right here, the number two qualifier, his opponent, Troy Critchley. But anything could happen, Kenny.
You know, you can't look past one of Richard Patterson's cars, the PMS excavating guys out of Houston, Texas. Third final in a row, going for their second win in three events.
First off the starting line was Freddie Hahn, 469 to a 477. Oh, Critchley right winning. Hahn blows by him in the last couple hundred feet. Freddie Hahn slowed to a 626, 226 miles per hour. Wow, that was a drag race. Let's go to top end.
It wasn't a great pass, but we got to the winner's circle with it. You know, thanks to Matco Tools and AMS and everybody out here, NHRA Summit, you know, we're proud to be here. We're thrilled to death to be here and win the final at Englishtown.
Look at the leader, Thomas Patterson over the Iceman, Ricky Smith in a distant third, and Freddie Hahn made a big move in the fourth. That wraps it up from Englishtown, New Jersey. I'm Ted Jones for Brett Kepner and Kenny Nally. So long, everyone. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For more, log on to ESPN.com.